yourself.
Yeah.
Put it in your heart.
Yeah.
A recognition that the act that you did caused offense.
Yeah, yeah.
We offend God when we sin.
Yes.
It causes offense to the Holy God. What we did, how we acted, and what we didn't do.
Uh-huh.
You know what it does? It causes Jesus to be nailed.
That's right.
On the cross.
Jesus.
Oh, that feels all over again.
Jesus.
And every time we sin against God and we don't repent and get out of it and turn around, it's just like we nailing Jesus back to the cross.
Jesus.
Father!
Jesus.
Forgive me.
Yes.
I'm sorry!
Yes. Uh-huh.
When God speaks, listen.
Yes.
He speaks through his word.
Uh-huh.
He speaks in his spirit.
Uh-huh.
Anybody ever been in the spirit and presence of God and you can just feel and hear God speaking to your spirit? He speaks through gifts in the church.
Mm-hmm.
You know God put people in here.
Mm-hmm.
He gave the body gifts. For the edifying. It's not only the preacher and the teacher. God speaks through his gifts.
Yes, yes.
And he also speaks through his shepherd.
Yes. Amen.
Will you listen?
Yes.
St. John 10:27 and 28, it reads, My sheep.
Yes.
Jesus said, My sheep.
Uh-huh.
Hear my voice.
Yes.
And I know them.
Uh-huh.
And they follow me.
Yes.
And I give unto them eternal life.
Yes.
And they shall never perish. Neither shall any man pluck out of my hand.
Yes.
Use your eyes.
Yes.
Spend time reading God's word. When you open your Bible, before you even read a word, ask God. Say, God, give me understanding of your word.
Yes.
Not only read it, but you should study it. Meditate on it. Speak it. You know it's good to speak God's word.
Yes, yes.
It's food.
Yes.
For your very soul.
Yes.
Use your feet. Your 2 feet. Find yourself in the house of God.
All right, all right.
Fellowship with like believers.
Jesus.
It's a dangerous world out there.
Yes, yes.
And sometimes it just feel good to know there's somebody. There's some folk. That have your back.
Yes, yes.
That's praying for you.
Uh-huh.
That's holding you up at the throne of God.
Jesus.
Oh, yeah. Feels mighty good.
Yes.
They don't mind worshiping with you. Uh-huh. They don't look at your fight.
Yes, yes.
When you wave your hand.
Yes.
Oh, thank you.
Yes, Lord.
You feel good.
Yes, Jesus.
To be around.
Yes, Jesus.
Like-minded.
Yeah, yeah.
He put people in his church
mm-hmm.
to support, encourage.
Yes.
He wants us to share what God has been doing in our lives.
Yes, yes.
Did you all hear Missionary Band in the day?
Yes, yes.
Did you hear her?
Uh-huh.
God told us to make known
his
deeds.
Uh-huh.
And what it does, it builds our faith.
Mm-hmm.
So you know what, Missionary Bay? I'm going to keep doing what I do.
Yes, yes.
I'm going to keep doing it.
Yes.
Because God, if he healed her, he can heal you.
Yes.
If he delivered you,
yes.
He can deliver you.
Yes.
We're supposed to make known him
yes.
among the saints of God.
Yes.
And that would edify.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
And we can also learn from one another. But of course, wherever there is people, there's usually offense.
Yes.
Offense.
And
hurt. That come with people. Where people gather.
Yes.
Intentionally, unintentionally.
Yes.
Sometimes there's offense. Sometimes there's hurt.
Yes.
But even in that, God expects us to reconcile. God expects that of
us. Yes.
To reconcile.
Yes. Yes.
And walk in forgiveness.
Yes, Jesus.
Bishop, so use this scenario. Start kicking people out of the church. Gonna start kicking them out.
Come on. Come on.
You don't deserve God.
Yes, come on.
Kick
him out. Come on.
Well, keep kicking. After a while, there ain't gonna be but one in here. And then God.
Gonna kick you out. Yes, it is. Come on. Yes, come on.
The church is like a hospital.
Yes.
The emergency room.
Yes.
Others is only critical care unit.
Yes.
While others may be ministering. But whether you in the emergency room. In a critical care.
Come on.
You will speak.
Yes.